two picks in this year's NBA draft face off tonight in Los Angeles when Karl Anthony Towns and D'Angelo Russell make their debuts. But according to odds makers, neither are the favorite to win Rookie of the Year. 76ers center Jahlil Okafor is a 3-1 favorite, while Towns and Russell are 5-1 and 6-1 favorites, respectively. Stephen A., who's going to win Rookie of the Year?
I got to tell y'all something.
Okay.
First of all, let's understand this. Karl Anthony Towns deserves to be the favorite to capture Rookie of the Year honors. The reason that I say that, Skip Bayless, is because not only is he going to be your starter at the five, I spoke to Coach Sam Mitchell on my radio show for the Minnesota Timberwolves yesterday as well. And by the way, Skip, let's take a quick moment to pay our respects to the late, great Flip Saunders,
definitely. Yes.
Head coach, president of the Timberwolves, and his passing. A wonderful guy.
God
we worked
bless.
With him here at ESPN. Obviously, Coach, God bless him and his family. Let's just say that.
Yep.
But when you look at Karl Anthony Towns, they've got him starting at the five. So because he's going to start at the five and he's being schooled and tutored by KG and he could also play that stretch four, he's going to be in position to put up some decent numbers. And he's got the inside track on that. The reason why I don't consider him a lock, however, for Rookie of the Year, Skip, is because he's playing around a bunch of young guys. I'm not sold on Ricky Rubio, even though he's not that young. He's been around long enough. But Zach LaVine is his backup. Shabazz Muhammad at the three, who loves to shoot. You're looking at Andrew Wiggins, who's going to be at the two. Not sure about that.
Yep.
Here's the guys that I keep my eyes on. Stanley Roberts in Detroit, out of Arizona.
Mm-hmm.
I like his chances to win Rookie of the Year. And Emmanuel Mudiay for Denver, who went to China and was supposed to be at SMU with Larry Brown. Those are the two that I think could knock Karl Anthony Towns off for Rookie of the Year. I'm not putting D'Angelo Russell because he's young, and I'm not putting Jahlil Okafor because he plays for the Sixers, who I think will suffer again this year.
Mm. No Porzingis in that conversation?
Mm.
He might deserve it. We'll see.
Okay. You know how much I love Karl Anthony Towns because I told you before the draft, for months before the draft, that would be my guy. I think he will prove to be a better NBA player than Jahlil Okafor. I could also see Okafor easily winning Rookie of the Year just because he's got an NBA body already. I'm not sure about Karl Anthony's physique yet. I'm not sure about his physicality. And even though we know the Sixers are not going to be very good either, I think that Okafor is going to be a fairly dominating rookie player. And I agree with the odds. I would give him the best shot to win. Now, I'm a big Mudiay guy, too. And I told you, I thought the Knicks missed the boat, not taking him over Porzingis. Larry Brown said this is his guy, that Larry would think about taking him in the first couple of picks in the draft. So I'm watching closely on Mudiay. But go ahead.
I meant Stanley Johnson, not Stanley Roberts.
Yeah, I got it. I knew what you were talking about.
Stanley Johnson.
I used to like Stanley Roberts, too, once upon a time.
But, yes.
Okay.
Upon a time.
All right. My point is, I'm surprised you're giving Okafor no credit here. You're just dismissing him from this conversation. You didn't bring him up.
Only because, because I think the Sixers are going to stink. I think that we need to look at Sam Hinkie, the general manager, who openly tanked one season and arguably tanked three. And at some point in time, whether it's Nerlens Noel being drafted while he's hurt, whether it's Joel Embiid being drafted while he's hurt, we have to start looking at the Philadelphia 76ers in the fourth largest market in America and saying, could you win some damn games for the city there? Jahlil Okafor can play. It won't be his fault, but the team is going to suffer. They're not going to be very good. That's why I couldn't consider him. It has nothing to do with him.
Okay, and I'm going to remind you of this one more time. Bobby, my new Spur, 7'3" Serbian, is a rookie. He's 27 years old, but he qualifies, I'm pretty sure, as a rookie. Let's not dismiss him from this conversation.
A 27-year-old rookie?
Yeah.
I'm not sure about that. That's like senior citizen status for rookies. I don't like giving them that.
Well,
I don't like putting them
in. I'm pretty sure he's qualified.
I know, but you better watch it.
I'm looking for pops and flashes, just like crazy in football. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Come on, man.
Dez Bryant will take part in practice Wednesday for the first time since suffering a foot injury in week one, a source told ESPN Cowboys reporter Todd Archer. Bryant is likely to be limited in his first work with teammates in more than 6 weeks, but his participation is a positive sign toward playing Sunday against the Seattle Seahawks.
Mm.
Skip Bayless, Dez could be back.
Dez.
Is he going to play Sunday?
God, you're. I think I should do this, yeah. Right? It's been a long time
just
since I got
it.
To
just
do
hold
this,
it.
Stephen A.
Good, I'm just, a single just, shot.
Just for the feel goodness of it. Okay.
He's ignoring us.
Now, back to objectivity.
Yeah.
I guess there's a chance Dez Bryant will attempt to play against the Seattle Seahawks at Jerry World on Sunday. I'm going to go Stephen A. on the Steelers. As we heard earlier in this show, Stephen A. Smith took the stance that he does not want Big Ben to play yet. He should save himself to make sure he's ready to go for the back half of the season by not playing this Sunday against the Cincinnati Bengals in Pittsburgh. That was Stephen A.'s earlier stance on this show. I'm going to take a similar one here on Dez. I do not want him to play against the Rough Riders that are the Seattle Seahawks Legion of Boom. I don't think it is worth the risk because, and I'm going to be honest about this, Stephen A., I do not like my team's chances against the Seahawks at Jerry World this Sunday. Seattle owes Dallas. Dallas embarrassed Seattle at Seattle, as you recall, last year. The Legion of Boom snacks on backup quarterbacks like Matt Cassel. In fact, it'll be the equivalent. Matt Cassel will be like Oberto beef jerky, just another piece of beef jerky for Richard Sherman.
You get out.
To what you get, what you put in. Yeah, we get it. And so
love
that
Oberto.
Little voice in my stomach, you know, Richard will be dropping a little Oberto Cassel jerky down his throat to you this time. I just don't love it. I'm sorry. It's the wrong place, wrong time. If I'm Dez, I wait one more week just to make sure that your surgery will take and hold. And let's go ahead and let it all fly against the Eagles the following week at Jerry World. I'm okay with that. I just don't like our chances this week against the Seahawks at home, where the Cowboys notoriously don't play very well anyway. Your thoughts, Mr. Smith?
Well, Skip Bayless, first of all, let me say to you that I'm very, very proud of the position that you've taken. I mean, the fact that, you know, you seem to be echoing my sentiments, I mean, it just shows that you're with
me. I'm learning.
Learning from the best.
On a daily basis.
At the foot of the master.
I'm just touched by that.
Yeah.
I'm just
I even worked in Oberto. How good was that?
Hey, listen, man. I was just talking to somebody yesterday, you know, and they were talking to me about how if you go on Siri and you say Stephen A. Smith is sounds like it's saying Stephen Naismith. So I love it. I love it. I give you credit for all of that because that's my favorite nickname of all.
You did. Listen. You invented
but
the sport of basketball,
when it comes to
Stephen
basketball,
Naismith. Yes.
Not just when it comes to basketball, evidently. You listen on other things as well. Because Dez doesn't need to rush back. Why rush back for this? I mean, that's what this comes down to. What he needs to do is use these next couple of weeks to get himself in pristine condition.
Yep.
So when Tony Romo comes back, he's ready to aid Tony Romo. Because one would argue that whether it's Brandon Whedon due to bad luck or Matt Cassel with his QBR of 17 from last week with 17 of 27 passing for 227 yards, one touchdown, three interceptions. You know, there's but so much that Dez Bryant is going to be able to do if you got quarterbacks that tap dance excessively when pressure is applied in the pocket, when can't see over the line of scrimmage for whatever reason, or wants to throw a football that has more air under it, that is almost like floating in a balloon for crying out loud, which is one of the passes, one of the interceptions that Matt Cassel threw.
Yep.
So when you look at it from that perspective, I totally agree with you. I think it's entirely wise for Dez Bryant to wait. I think it's entirely wise for Dez Bryant not to rush back. It's good that he's back there practicing. I'll put up the X for you, make you feel better. Mm-hmm. But in the end, that's in practice. In the end, that's during the week. He has no business on the field in game time until, as far as I'm concerned, Tony Romo gets back, because there's little to nothing he's going to be able to do to help the Cowboys prior to that.
And I will remind you, most athletes who suffer this injury, this Jones fracture, take at least 3 months to get right from it. Now Dez Bryant's about to be 6 weeks into his rehab. I don't know. I don't love it. I'm sorry. Yeah, don't rush it.
At least take a 2 full months off, which means an additional 2 to 3 weeks from now. before. I know it's hard because you're a Cowboy, and obviously they've lost four straight, and then you're looking at the possibility of them losing 6 to 7 straight. I know.
Make it 8. Make it 9. Who cares?
I get it. But I just think that, you know what? He should hold out for at least a couple of more weeks before he even considers getting back on the field.
Listen, maybe it's going to uplift the team in practice today.
It might.
Maybe.
And, you know,
maybe I wouldn't rule it out, Skip.
Who knows? Maybe the Giants will lose at New Orleans. You never know. Could they? Maybe.
It's possible. Okay. It's possible, Skip. I mean, listen, we can't rule anything out.
Nope, we can't.
There's still
hope. We could rule that in, maybe.
There's still hope for your Cowboys.
Another bold prediction. I'll wait for that one. I'll wait for that for later in the week. We already had the Raiders.
Mm-hmm.
All right, moving on, back to hoops. Karl Anthony Towns makes his NBA debut tonight versus the Lakers. Is he a lock for Rookie of the Year? Mm-hmm. The guys will debate that next.